Hello and welcome to this final lecture of multi-level modeling. And I would say, I think one of the most complex, but maybe also the most exciting things we can do with multi-level modeling is the randomization of the slope. What does it mean? Well, actually, I need to show you a picture. And yeah, it doesn't matter so much what kind of picture. So a randomization of the slope means that a lowest level predictor, the slope of the lowest level predictor, you do not want to estimate that slope for the whole sample, but now you say, okay, I want to see whether or not the slope on the individual level of the individual level predictor actually is significantly different when we look at the slopes of different teams. So for instance, in team one, work pressure or autonomy in our case could have like a positive relationship with, in this case, performance. But maybe in some other team, work pressure or autonomy as predictors could have a negative relationship with performance, right? Or maybe there's no relationship in some other team. So you want to see a multi-level for Windows or any multi-level modeling software can do is to estimate variances of the slope if these variances of the slope within each of the teams are significantly different from one another. Yeah, so the way to do that is you can tell the program to say, okay, we have here work pressure, and we want work pressure, the slope of work pressure to freely vary across all of the teams we have examined. Then we can press start. And here we have an estimate and a standard error for the randomization of this slope. And this is actually still the estimate while taking into account the randomization of the slope. So you see here, if you divide 0.155 by 0.055, you see that work pressure is still significantly and positively related to individual performance. But you also see here, it's just not significant, I guess. So the randomization of the slope, we can calculate this for work pressure. So we have here the randomization of the slope, B1j, B1j for work pressure, B1j. Is 0.088. Oh nay, 0.088. I will never get it right tonight. And the standard error is 0.053. So if we divide the two, for work pressure, you see that there is the z values below 1.96. So for work pressure, there is no significant randomization of the slope across the teams. So most of the time you want to predict only one random slope because it's pretty complex to run the analysis for the program. And especially if you have a little bit of a low number of teams, you maybe not even want to do that. So you should look at the slides, but I think I tell you somewhere that you need at least 50 teams to do this kind of randomization of the slope. According to the statisticians, you need a significant amount of observations on the team level, at least 50. Right now we see that for autonomy, you have a significant variance. Because now it says BG2J, so this is the second predictor on the individual level, and we asked MLWin to calculate if the random slopes on the team level are actually significantly different from one another, right? So we have here B2J, autonomy, randomization of the slope for autonomy is now. And oh yeah, I actually have now a new model, so I should actually put it here. Is 0.071. It's this one, and the error term is 0.029. So here, higher than 1.96. So we have p is lower than 0.05, which is significant. You can look at the n. Let's look at the n pro. N pro. We should command n pro. Oh, n pro is 2.44 or something. 2.448. Like, so we have to multiply this. If you have, so we have a one-tailed test, and this is a two-tailed p-value. But you could say that if you have a hypothesis that, in this case, autonomy leads to a higher, more autonomy leads to higher levels of individual performance, which is theoretic, from a theoretical perspective in our field. It's a very how do you say this? Yeah, this is a normal prediction, right? This is a one-tailed prediction. So then we have one, let's say 0.014, right? Times two. 0.014. Okay. And actually we have now a whole new model. So you can enter all of these variables again. Shall we do that? Take some time. Let's do that. Where's the model equations? And it's gone because this is another spreadsheet. Here they are. The constant is 3.57. Maybe you can fast forward this. So we will type in all of the variables again. So the fixed slope for work pressure is 145. So I will just enter all of the variables again. And now we have here B2J, which is the slope here. It's just the thing here, 3.830. Oh, this is my daughter crying. Uh-oh. Well, I have to pause this. So, settle that little crisis. Team size. Where's the model here? Team size 2.4. 0.13. So, and then we have team KPI and 3. 0.45. So, and we have the randomized slope and the team level 83 and the individual level 187 and the deviant score 707.258 is. So what you see here actually, I will not do everything again. I would recommend you to just look at the previous lectures and you will see how to calculate this. So we see here, this is an extra, I would say 1 degree of freedom extra, because we randomized the slope. which is an extra thing we did. If you would test the chi-square, you would see that this chi-square is significant increase in model fit or decrease of the deviance. So we have a better model fit because this is actually a model 3, I would say. Model 3, where we have all of the indicators again. Well, what? The estimate divided by the standard error. Bloop, 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 bloop. This one is significant, right? You can calculate that exactly, but let's look. So this is 0 below, and this is also below, yeah, because it's higher than 1.96. So we see here that, like, we can compare it. So work pressure still predicts performance, right? Positively predicts performance, or at least is related, because this is cross-sectional data. So work pressure is positively related to individual performance. And then team KPI, as we already saw here, it is still positively related. So the higher the team level performance, the higher the employee level performance, right? So positively associated or related to one another. But now we see that it is interesting, eh? So based on normal regression, or normal multi-level regression, you would say, okay, autonomy does not have an effect. But here you see autonomy varies, so there's null effect. It varies. It has a significant variance depending across the different teams with the z-value and a p-value. So you could say that in some teams, autonomy does lead to an increase in performance, whereas maybe in other teams it does not, and then the average effect, if you do not randomize the slope, is 0. But we do have a randomized effect. So now what we can actually do is make the final model, and then I will stop these video lectures because my daughters want to hear a bedtime story. But let's see. Performance model 4, let's be a bit quick. And okay, we could repeat all of these variables again, but now I will show you what we can do. So we can also try to predict why this actually varies significantly. So we can look at interactions between first level indicators and second level indicators. So we could, for instance, and then we talk about cross-level moderation, actually. So we can look at the effect of, so I did this too fast, sorry, I am a bit in a hurry. Adder, order 1, then we can click on autonomy and team size, right? So if we press start, we see here the estimate is 0.01 and the SE is 0.017. So if you divide the two, you would see that this has no significant effect. So the cross-level interaction effect of autonomy and team size is not significant. But as I already showed you in the slides of the lecture, this one is. You see? And then actually this effect goes down a little bit. You see that? Now, okay, we make this final model with the cross-level interaction effect. So we have autonomy times team KPI, right? There's an extra term that can explain why the slopes vary. And now I need to freeze my panes. Freeze panes, where do I have that? Freeze panes, please. Not here. I don't see it. Control here. Oh, it's Dutch. Blokkeren. Would that be? Blokkeren. Yeah, okay. Freeze panes is blokkeren in Dutch. I didn't know that actually. I always use an English version, but apparently I have now a Dutch. Okay. So, okay, you can see that you can fill out all of these indicators again, right? But there are two very important. I will add them here. 0.062. And is this correct? No. So I will here enter the effect of the interaction. 1.38. 1.38. 0.58. And we can also look at now if this variation is still significant, the variation of the slope. And it appears, it appears it has 0.062, please. Ah. Right. Oh yeah, and then let's add. So actually you have here also a z value, right? So this is I'm going crazy. Oh, this was already the z value, so I'm sorry about that. Verwijderen. So this is like the estimate and the SE of the randomized slope. This is the p-value, and now we again have, in this model, with the interaction effect, these figures, right? So, and now, the cross-level interaction, you can also look at here. We have above 0.196, so we have a significant interaction effect of, and now still I need everything, but okay. We have a significant interaction effect, oh, it's not 3, but it's lower than 0.05. Cross-level interaction effect, and you see here that the t value drops a little bit, so it explains a little bit, a tiny part of why the slope is random across the team. So there is some kind of cross-level interaction going on between autonomy and team KPI. And then, for your convenience, I will just pause this. And then add all of the terms here, and then I will show you how you can actually interpret this cross-level interaction effect. So here I am again. I have filled out all of the indicators. So what we finished. Oh yeah, I just paused the video, but you can see still that the interaction, the cross-level interaction effect, it has a significant value. What you can also, for instance, calculate if we, whether or not this cross-level interaction effect leads to a significant decrease in chi-square. So the chi-square difference is also significant, meaning that the model, including the cross-level interaction, has a better fit as compared to without the model without that interaction. You can also look at the individual z-values again, of course. And, oh, I forgot to do the variance explained, but okay, you can look at the previous videos. What I want to show you now is how to interpret this cross-level interaction effect. And actually, you need the estimate and the standard error of the predictor, and the estimate and the standard error of what is called the moderator, in this case, team KPI. And as I advise in the slides, you can use this website, Jeremy Dawson. You go to two-way unstandardized slopes. And by the way, you can only use this for like the interpretation of what's going on. If you want to conduct official, yeah, like multi-level, cross-level interaction analysis, you should use a different method. But this is beyond the limits of this course, so I will only show you how you can a little bit see what is going on, right? So you click here, and then what I did is here I filled out this spreadsheet, and it looks at autonomy one standard deviation below the mean, and high autonomy meaning one standard deviation above the mean, right? Same for team KPI. And then what I actually do, I fill out the estimate. So yeah, it's a bit tricky this maybe. Okay. This is like the final exercise 4E. So we look at individual independent variable. Autonomy has estimate 0.04, right? So I fill out 0.04. The moderator team KPI has an estimate here of 0.192. The interaction has 0.138, so the unstandardized estimate is here 0.138. And we have a mean of 3.95. Intercept constant is 3.95. We center these variables on the grand mean, remember? So the grand mean of the moderator and the independent variable is 0 for the sample. And then actually you can calculate the standard deviation. Most of the time you use SPSS, but you can also go to basic statistics, averages and correlations, and then click on these, and then averages, team KPI, and autonomy. If you select those and you click calculate, you get the standard deviation of them. Okay, so we're going on for 20 minutes now, so I will finish off, finish this video. So yeah, you see, how can you interpret this? Well, when people have higher levels of, the higher the level of autonomy of people or of employees, the better their individual performance is in teams that have high levels of team performance. But the reverse, it appears that the reverse is true for teams with low levels of KPI. So when a team is not performing well, or at least one standard deviation below the mean, then you see that higher levels of autonomy do not increase individual level performance, but it slightly decreases individual level performance. So, okay, and of course it depends on what kind of theoretical model you have, and did you actually predict this interaction effect? That's of course very important. So I want to just finish, and thank you for your attention. And I hope these video lectures were useful for you. And yeah, I hope they help you in not only making group assignment 2. I hope you found this video lectures interesting. Yeah, there are some new techniques you can use in general linear modeling techniques that I think they cannot only be applied to our field of research, but are generally useful in all kinds of research, right? So I'm going on for too long. So thank you for listening, and I wish you a lot of luck with a lot of success with making group assignment 2. And I hope you also enjoy the rest of the course. Okay, thanks. Bye.